Hello everyone, welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. It is Francesco here. In today's video, I'm going to be passing over to William Nutt, who runs Nutt Lamps. And they are basically a Notion consultancy, but they also do a fantastic newsletter and resource called Notion VIP, which is perfect for those who are building out their Notion. Now, I actually checked out their product, Notion Charts, which has been on Product Hunt for a while. So in today's video, I'm actually going to pass over to Will, who's actually going to dive into the charts, how to create one, and how to embed one inside of your Notion account. So thank you very much to Will for coming on, and I will pass over to Will, guys. And I hope you have a fantastic weekend. If you're new here, subscribe to both Will and I. I'll see you in a bit, guys. Cheers.
Thanks so much, Francesco. It's a pleasure to join you. As Francesco mentioned, I'm William Nutt of Nutt Labs, and we're an integrated digital strategy firm and Notion consultancy based in New York. And I also run the website Notion VIP, where I publish tools and insights about all things Notion. And among those tools is Notion Charts, which you can access at notion.vip/charts. And Notion Charts allows any user to create charts and embed them in their Notion pages. And those charts are styled and generated specifically for Notion so they weave nicely into your page's content. So in the sample dashboard, you can see that we have a variety of different chart types. And these charts are going to use the same colors that you can use for your text in Notion. And they're also interactive, so you can hover over them to reveal additional information. So until Notion releases its API, these charts are going to pull their information dynamically from Google Sheets. And that means you can update the information easily, and you can even automate it using Google Sheets integrations. So let's take a look at how it works. The first step is preparing your Google Sheet. And within Notion Charts, under the Data Range field, you're going to have a link to some demo data. And that demo data shows you just how to structure your data for the various chart types. So you can see here that we have sample data for line charts, bar and column charts, pie and donut charts, and then geo charts. So let's use the line chart data to create a line chart that showcases consulting income by month. With your data properly structured, you want to ensure that your sheet is publicly accessible. We're going to use Notion's API to accommodate private data, so in the meantime, you're not going to want to use Notion Charts for any sensitive information. So you'll click the Share button at the top of the screen, and you'll just ensure that anyone with the link can view the document. And then you want to copy your sheet ID, and you'll do that by grabbing the series of characters between the D slash and the slash edit. So you'll copy that, and you'll go back over into Notion Charts, and you'll paste it in the first field. And then you need the sheet name or the tab name of your document. In our case, that's Data Structures. And then you want the precise data range. So for our line chart, that's going to be A3 by B15. And then you can customize your chart. So for the chart type, ours is going to be a line chart, which is the default. And then you can choose light mode or dark mode. And then you'll choose the formatting for your axes labels. So we're working with dates and currency. So we're going to choose our formatting accordingly. And then you'll choose your colors. As I mentioned, you can choose among the same colors that you use for your text in Notion, and for this chart, a line chart, we're just going to have one color. Let's use that Notion pink. And then the last step is to opt in to the Notion VIP newsletter, which of course I recommend. And then you'll hit the Make Magic button. And what that's going to do is it's going to generate a special URL that you can copy in just a click. And then you'll jump over into Notion. And you'll paste that special URL. And when you do that, you'll have the option to create embed. And boom, there's your chart, which you can resize. And as you resize it to fit nicely within your content, you'll see the chart respond in real time. Now, if this last step gives you any trouble, be sure to use the Notion desktop app instead of the web app, because that embed block can be a little finicky within the web app. But once you get the chart in place, it's going to display properly everywhere. And that's Notion Charts. I'd love to see what you come up with using the tool. Feel free to pass along any of your creations on Twitter. My handle is at WilliamNutt. And thanks so much for tuning into this quick demo. And be sure to check out Notion VIP for some additional resources about Notion.